Welcome to Silverstone, home of the British Grand Prix. This iconic track held the very first World Championship Formula One race back in 1950, and it's a firm favourite amongst the fans and drivers alike. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
But from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Verstappen, Vettel, Pierre Gasly, and Perez, Hülkenberg, Ricciardo, Norris, and Carlos Sainz, Magnussen, Raikkonen, Romain Grosjean, and Kvyat, Stroll, Russell, Alexander Albon, and Antonio Giovinazzi. Kubica and Lewis Hamilton rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, be wary of the cars ahead breaking suddenly into one. We could ruin our race if we hit them. Good luck. Let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. back confirmed. Charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy. Some information on Grosjean. They seem to have an issue. Gap to teammate ahead is 14.3 seconds. Valtteri is in for his stop. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Go, go now. Out. We have excess fuel weighing us down. Set the fuel mix to mode 3. Let's push. Maneuver. You made it look easy. If we turn down the ERS deployment, Gasly is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 4.9 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 2 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 35.4. Gap behind. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Ahead. Our gap to the car in front is 2.7 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 3 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:35.1. The gap to the car ahead is 2.1 seconds. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
That's a fantastic performance from Ferrari. It hardly looked in doubt. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day, and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace, and our winner today showed they could do both.
Ferrari are at it again, an excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
It's got to be Lewis Hamilton. I mean, he pulled off some impressive feats out on the track today, even by his standards.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.